men's high jump final night at the Olympic Stadium. A really exciting field. It's always an exciting competition, this one. They are so beautiful to watch, the high jumpers. The bar will start at 220, and, well, it could get beyond 240 by the time it finishes. And there's Sotomayor's world record of 245, and the last of the Americans to win was Charles Austin back in Atlanta, and maybe the 239, his 239 will be challenged. Here's the field.
Yeah, Brendan Stark here of Australia. He's gone around that 2 metres 30 previously. Here at Kinnard of the United States, really comes into here as one of the favourites. It's probably the most open field I've seen in a major high jump or an Olympic Games in a long time. So it's really going to be about form on the night. It's going to be about rhythm. It's going to be making sure that they get approach to the bar correct. The higher the bar goes, the subtle adjustments they will need to make with their run-ups.
One of the veterans now from Canada, 33 years of age, Derek Druin.
Yeah, now he's got a very unusual takeoff. He tends to look more like a long jumper with the way he uses his arms, and he's a very rigid jumper. He tends to not quite have the flexibility some of the other jumpers have.
Well, he's got the clearance though, he's got the height. He was way above that. He's almost tall enough to just go right over the top, isn't he? He bounded into that one, you're right, a different style and good to look at.
Oh, bordering on arrogance, and I certainly mean no disrespect. That's me saying that, not him. Well done, Derek Druin. Outstanding.
Favourite, or one of the favourites. There he is from Qatar, straight into it. He did not waste any time at all. Didn't want anyone to look at him other than going over the bar. He decided to go at the 220 and not pass, and that's why. He just wanted to have some fun.
Yeah, and look, you can sit there and you can overthink it at times, and in that split second of hesitation, you can actually get it wrong. Just get the momentum going, get the rhythm. Doesn't quite take the same amount of time in terms of his build-up.
Twitter and Facebook fans everywhere barracking. We'll start. We move on.
Well, all too easy for Montarico.
In the competition for the first time, he passed at the 220. Comes in at the 225, and you get an idea why he passed. That was amazing. Nearly jumped it standing up, upright.
And I think maybe part of that, I'm not sure that we're going to see the psychological wars just yet, but it's also just a sign of confidence. Hey, guys, I'm not going to do 220. I'm happy at 225. And he will repeat this every time he jumps. This is automatic for him. This is just habit.
He bounds in, and he bounds over. He's got a different look, and he's got a look of confidence, hasn't he?
He is the one guy that does seem to be able to just generate the power through the vertical side of the jump. He's not requiring so much on the angles.
Here we have one of the stars of the show. He was quick to go at 220, taking a little bit more time now. Mumtaz Essebsiham of Qatar. He's jumped 243. Only one man has jumped more than that.
Oh, and that is comfortable too. And he does come off the slightly shorter run-up. Doesn't come in with as much speed. Comes in on a little bit more of what they call the, well, traditional sort of J-shape approach. He just comes off a shorter run-up. Unorthodox but very effective Derek Druin of Canada, one of the real favourites. You would think that he's doing either the long jump or the triple jump. Seventh at Monaco in the recent Diamond League meet, one of the last real lead-in events to this. Wow. That's all you can say is wow. Very comfortable. Hasn't looked challenged so far.
You like him, don't you? You liked him from the start.
Yeah, I do like him. There's been a real buzz around him, and I think he draws attention because of the unique way in which he does jump. I mean, this was the qualifying mark. 11 of them got over it. As we see now Basham. And comfortably over it, the man from Qatar.
26 years of age, silver medalist at the World Championships last year, was a gold medalist at the World Champs back in 2013. Here he goes, Roden Marenko. Yep, not a problem in the world. He might have another spell after that. He's a massive man, isn't he? It's a big frame, and he's having a bit of fun out there as well, to an extent, although that was just perhaps the mind not concentrating on everything that it should be.
His sister was a national champion in high jump in Canada, Jill Droid. I think he's starting to send just a little bit of a psychological statement.
Gabaz is still talking to the officials, who are talking to each other.
So Basham. Oh, again, comfortable. He likes it. Raises the one arm. I've got a feeling we could be in for something special tonight. So they are still going to contest the rules with the white flag, though. And Druin comfortably over it. Look what it means to him. You talk about rhythm, you talk about consistency. This man is the metaphor for it at the moment. That is a very good jump. Making a statement once again. Mutaz Ezebashim at 2 metres and 36 centimetres. Oh, that is a good jump too. The fist pumping. Pressure starts to go on everybody, but the man from Qatar rises to the occasion. If you want to look at technique, that there is a great example of everything that you need to do right. He's on his way. And he doesn't.
It has to drive the body, the lead arm high to guide the body over. He went through it in his mind. It's now time to do it. And Derek Druin, oh, he can do it all right. He can do it. Celebrates and says, hey, have a look at that. Have a look at that. You've got to come and catch me now. The first one over 2:38. The Canadians in the house. They're on their feet. And wow, he was flying through the air, Derek Druin, wasn't he? Let's have a look at it. The heels climb. He tucks the chin. The rest of the body follows. Crashes into the mat. He's already an Olympic medalist here in Rio. We know that there's only three of them there. Was that a gold medal jump?
Well, if this height's not the gold medal jump, the form suggests that he is the athlete to beat. He didn't just get over that, he got over that comfortably. Basham, Mutaz Ezebashim, 25 years of age. And again, he comes up short.
This is real Olympic pressure here. Is he up to it? It's not to be for Basham tonight. He is out, three times out at 2:38. He will take a medal, and that's why he is celebrating, and so he should. Just 25 years of age, he'll get better and better. He's doing it for Qatar. He was doing it in style, not quite here though. Never really got there, so he's out at 2:38, and depending what happens, he could be a silver or a bronze medalist here, because we know Derek Druin is over at 2:38. So we have two in at the 2:40, but the problem is, well, it's not a problem at all for Derek Druin. It's good for him that Bodan Bondarenko only has one attempt. He's heading towards the top of the runway now, and he's ready to go.
So Bodan Bondarenko. This to definitely move into the silver medal place, but to continue the challenge for the gold, Derek Druin of Canada waits. Now the pressure goes on because that clock is running down. Around 30 seconds left for him. He did the right thing, though. 26 seconds goes.
Did he? These athletes will have practiced this as well. They would have practiced having to change their warm-up, their technique, and just do it to time. Still makes it so, so tough.
Bondarenko, cometh the hour, cometh the man. Can this become one of the great Olympic moments? Oh, Derek Drouin of Canada, there is your gold medalist. Well done, he's looked bulletproof all night. Bondarenko will settle for the bronze medal. Congratulations to the man from Qatar who will take the bronze medal. Mutaz Issa Bajin, the silver medal. Just great respect for the sport too, though.
Look at that, picture of concentration. A few words for himself, a private moment, and we all get along. Not this time for Drouin, and it looks as if he'll say that'll do. That will do, I don't have to go again. That's his first mistake. But it didn't matter, it was only for fun. He was chasing an Olympic record because he is already an Olympic champion. Derek Drouin of Canada wins the men's high jump Rio 2016. To Derek Drouin, he is the winner, the gold medalist.
I wonder whether he has maybe changed the technique of high jumping, because he's unorthodox, but he's very effective. He's a lot more upright. Do we start to see a shift towards the Derek Drouin style of jumping?
And then the minor medalist, Bondarenko, with the bronze. Barsham takes the silver.
And just confirming the results, Derek Drouin of Canada, 2 meters 38. Bashim of Qatar on the count back beats Bondarenko. He takes the silver medal. Bondarenko the bronze. Carbids will finish in fourth place. But all of these athletes should be incredibly proud of themselves. When you think of the number of people that are on the planet, these top 15 go higher than anybody else. Another outstanding Olympic Games high jump competition. This time, it is the Maple Leaf who will stand on the highest step of the Olympic podium.